This video was brought to you by the ILC. Welcome back once again to episode 18. In the previous episode, we found the difference quotient for a function. And in this episode, we're going to do it again, but this time for a rational function. It's going to go slightly differently from last time. Let's have a look. So in this question, I've asked you to find the difference quotient of the function 1 divided by x minus 2. If you watched the last episode, you'll have seen the equation f of x plus h minus f of x divided by h. I'd like to use a slightly different version of that equation for this problem. We'll just restate it as 1 divided by h times f of x plus h minus f of x. This is actually the same thing as the previous equation. It's stated a little bit differently to help you work through the fractions a little easier than last time. And this one's going to get a little bit messy with the fractions, so we need all the help we can get in that regard. Like last time, our first step is to find the f of x plus h, and then subtract the f of x from it, and then multiply times 1 over h. However, last time, the first step was difficult, and the second step wasn't bad. In this one, the first step's not bad, but the second one can get pretty tricky. Let's go ahead and do the same thing we did last time, and find the value of f of x plus h. Alright? If you remember what we did last time for our first step, when we did f of x plus h, all we did was replace this x with x plus h. Our equation will become 1 divided by x plus h minus 2. Not too bad, that's the end of the first step. However, in the second step, we are going to have to subtract f of x from that. To do that, I'd just like to reset up this equation I wrote previously. 1 over h times f of x plus h minus f of x. Well, we know that f of x plus h is this piece right here. We'll plug it in and replace f of x plus h with this that I've circled. We're also going to replace this f of x right here with this function, our original function. We're just going to plug both pieces in and rewrite the whole thing. So we'll have 1 over h times 1 over x plus h minus 2, and then we subtract 1 over x minus 2. Now, when you subtract fractions, it's not that easy. You're going to be tempted to subtract the denominators and then just be done with it. But to subtract a fraction correctly, you have to get an LCD before you go any further. A lot of people forget that. I don't want that to happen to you. So let's try to find what the LCD is supposed to be. Well, we have two fractions in here that need to be subtracted. One of them has a denominator of x plus h minus 2. That's going to have to be included in our LCD. The other one has x minus 2. That's also got to be included. Now we have to ask ourselves, how do we change this denominator to the LCD that we want? We can see that we have the x plus h minus 2 here already, but the LCD also includes the x minus 2. So let's make a note of that. This fraction is going to need x minus 2. So let's put it in. We're going to keep the 1 over h on the outside, and we'll have 1 over x plus h minus 2 still, but we have to put in the x minus 2 and multiply that on the top and the bottom. All right. Now we move on to the second fraction, which we are going to subtract. On the top we have 1 over x minus 2. The LCD already has x minus 2, but we need x plus h minus 2. We'll make a note of that there. That fraction's going to need x plus h minus 2. So we're going to multiply that on both the top and the bottom. Like that. Now that we have the same denominator on both of the fractions, it's okay to combine them. So now, we'll still have the 1 over h on the outside, but now we'll have 1 times x minus 2 minus 1 times x plus h minus 2, and that entire thing is going to be over the LCD, seeing as how they both have the same denominator. X plus h minus 2 times x minus 2. And right now, this looks kind of awful, so we're going to have to go ahead and simplify this. I promise you, once we simplify this, it's going to look a little bit better, but we're going to need another page to do that. As usual, the best way to simplify is to start by either FOILing or multiplying to get rid of those parentheses. So what we're going to do first is multiply the 1 times the x and the 1 times the negative 2, and the negative 1 times the x, and the negative 1 times the h, and the negative 1 times the negative 2. So we'll still have 1 over h on the outside with a big parentheses. 1 times x is x. 1 times negative 2 is negative 2. Negative 1 times x is negative x. Negative 1 times h is negative h. Negative 1 times negative 2 is positive 2. The denominator will stay the same. It's still x minus 2, x plus h minus 2. Now that everything's outside of the parentheses, we can either combine like terms or hopefully cancel things out to make this look a little nicer. Well, you may notice that we have a positive x right here and a negative x right here. Those can cancel out. We also have negative 2 and positive 2. Those cancel out as well. That leaves us with just negative h divided by x minus 2, x plus h minus 2, and it is still times 1 over h. Do you see something else we can cancel out? Seeing as how we have an h on the top and an h on the bottom, those h's will cancel out also. So when we cancel those out, on the top of the fraction, we no longer have negative h, we now have negative 1, divided by, again, x minus 2, x plus h minus 2. And it's still multiplied times something, but that something is just 1 over 1, so you don't even have to write it. Our final answer is simply this fraction that I'm boxing in. Negative 1 over x minus 2 times x plus h minus 2. And that is our difference quotient. So that can get kind of messy. As long as you're careful with your fractions, and you're good about combining your like terms and canceling out everything that you can, usually this will work out pretty well. Thanks for your patience. We'll catch you again next episode.